Hi everyone, welcome to the Java course. We are actually able to compare two primitives by doing something like this. When we use the two equal signs combined together, and when we run this printing statement, we will get false as the answer because A is not equal to B. The principle is that we compare the two primitives directly. So the two equal signs here would do the comparison for us. But how about comparing two objects that are created by us? It is not that easy in the situation like a computer class. Suppose I have a computer class and I have some instance variables, and then I create a constructor, and for simplicity I omit the accessors and the mutators. And in this case, if I have two computer objects, how can I compare the objects? Actually, we cannot simply use the equal signs like what we did for primitives. Let us see an example of creating two computer objects first. Okay, here I have two computer objects. One has a reference variable called server1, and the other computer object has a reference variable called server2. As long as we use the new keyword, we create a new object in the memory system. So actually for the two new keywords used here, we create two separate objects in the memory system. So we can say that use server1 and server2 is not pointing to the same object in the memory system. How can we know that? We can try to equate the two reference variables. And since the variables server1 and server2 are storing two different references, it is sensible for us to get false in this printing statement. Let me try to run it. Yes, the answer is false. Why false? Because we are comparing two references, and for the two reference variables, they have different objects pointed to, so they would have two reference contents for each of the reference variable. I can print each of the reference variables out. Okay, I'm going to print out the content stored in the two reference variables. What will I get? Yes, I could get two references. So in the computer system, the two objects are actually different, even though the content stored in the objects are the same. So for Java, we cannot say that the two computer objects are equal to each other if we simply use the two equal signs combined together. Why? Because we are simply comparing the references stored in each of the reference variables. So if we want to compare the contents of the two objects, how can we do that? We have to rely on the equals method. which was already inherited from the object class. So each of the user-defined classes would be able to inherit the equals method. More precisely, we have to overwrite the equals method inherited from the object class. If we don't inherit, if we don't override the equals method, what will we have? Let us see. Okay, this is the equals method inherited from the object class, which is some property that every user-defined class would have. Server1.equals bracket server2. In this notation, we are trying to compare the server1 against server2. It seems to us that we will get true because the contents of the objects are the same. But when we run it, we will still get false, which is not our desired answer. Because if we don't override the equals method, we are still comparing the references of the two objects. So I have to say something here. If we simply use the equals method inherited from the object class, we just do the shallow comparison of the references. So we are simply equivalent to using the two equal signs when we don't override the equals method. If we really want to compare the content stored in two objects, we have to do what is called a deep comparison. Okay, if we want to compare the instance variables contained in the two objects, we have to override the equals method. So how can we override the equals method? Let us see the implementation. We go back to the computer class. We have to create the equals method by myself. Okay, this is the equals method inherited from the object class. We can see that the formal parameter is an object reference to an object type. So in this case, we are going to compare two computer objects. But in order to override the equals method, we have to take care of the object type, which is the formal parameter of the equals method inherited from the object class. We have to remember that what we are going to compare are simply two computer objects, but not the object of object type. So we have one way to compare two computer objects. First, I need to downcast the reference variable to the computer type. What does it mean by that? Object class as the highest class in the Java class hierarchy. And computer is simply a subclass of the object class. So when we want to do the comparison of two computer objects, we have to downcast the OBJ object to the computer type. Okay, if we don't do the downcasting, we are not able to make use of the computer properties to do the comparison. Okay, this is something we need to return. The equals method would give us a Boolean value. So the return statement has to give us a Boolean value back. The comparison is like this. I would like to check that whether the first memory size is equal to the second memory size. Same for the storage size. So the first memory size is actually the instance variables of server 1 here, and the second memory size is actually the instance variables for server 2 here. So this is the formal parameter of the equals method, and if I call the equals method after overwriting it, server 2 now becomes the actual parameter. So the actual parameter would have its own memory size and its own storage size. And the first memory size and the storage size refer to the instance variable of server 1. This is one of the ways of doing the overriding of the equals method. Let me see the result. Save it. Run it. Okay, I will get true when I overwrite the equals method. Of course, the two equal signs would simply give me false, which is expected because we simply compare the two references. But if we do the deep comparison by overwriting the equals method, we will get true. What does it mean by that? It simply tells us that the two computer objects would have the same memory size as well as the same storage size. So we are able to really compare the contents of the two objects by overriding the equals method, which is inherited from the object class. This is one way of doing the overriding. We have another approach. Okay, this is just the return statement of the second approach. We can see that we really do the downcasting inside the return statement. And I also use this keyword. Why? Because when we compare two instance variables, we have to make sure that the computer knows which of which object is comparing to which object. For this keyword, we simply say that the server one is going to be the object. And for the second object referenced by server 2, we have to use the obj reference variable. Since we are comparing two computer objects, we have to do the downcasting from the object type to computer type. So on the right hand side of the two equal signs, we have to do the downcasting in this way. First, we provide the data type to be downcast, and then we tell the whole downcast object to get the memory size instance variable. And we can do the same thing for the storage size. This keyword is simply talking about the instance variables of server 1, and the right hand side here is simply talking about the instance variables of server 2. The downcasting is like this. We turn obj to computer type instead of using the original object type. And after we have downcast the obj, we can use the instance variables pertaining to the computer class to do the comparison. So let me see the result by running it. Yes, I can still get true as the answer when I want to compare two computer objects that are having the same memory size and the same storage size. So we can see that in order to compare two user-defined objects, we have to create our equals method by overriding the original equals method from the object class. And we have two ways to do so. One way involves turning the obj from object type to computer type first. And the second approach is simply doing the downcasting inside the return statement in addition to using the this keyword. So after the explanation, I would hope that you're able to understand the importance of overriding the equals method in comparing the contents of the two objects. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.